Welcome back to Series 3 of the Atari ST Nostalgia GFA Basic Tour. In part 29, we created some nice animations by buffering and swapping screens using the get and put commands. And in this video, I want to explore the other way to operate on screen memory to make this animation, and then see if we can optimize the routines a bit with what we learned so far in this series. And I've been fooling around a little bit in direct mode in GFA Basic to acquaint myself again with the get and put commands. So as you see, I defined a nice fill, drew a box, used the get command to get that box into memory, into the variable box string, and then used the put command twice to put it at two locations of my screen. And yeah, it still works, it's really cool. But the get and put commands, because they are graphics commands, they have some limitations. Because if I want to get a screen area from somewhere on the fly, for instance, I would have to set that screen as my logical screen, because that's what the get command is operating on. Then do the get command, and if I want to put it somewhere else in a different screen, I have to again swap screens, set my logical screen to that destination screen, and then do the put command, which will be, yeah, apart from probably not very much having much performance, it will be very confusing and very cumbersome to code. So wouldn't it be great if we had a command that just copied the source raster over to a destination raster, without needing to switch between screens, just like the flexibility that bmove was providing us in part 31 compared to the sget and sput command. And the good news is, yes, we can do this. And the command is called rccopy or rastercopy. And the way the command works is basically, instead of getting something into variables, into memory, I can just type in the command directly, which basically said, I do the RC copy. It wants to have a source address where it should be looking from. So in this case, I will type xbios2 because I want to copy directly from the current screen. And then we have to set some source coordinates, which in this case is 400 by 100. And then it wants the dimension of the raster that it's supposed to copy. So in this case, it's 69 pixels by 32 pixels. And then, of course, I have to tell it in one go where to copy it to. In this case, I will also copy it to the same screen. But remember, this can be any address in memory, apart from the parts where I'm not allowed to route, but it can be any place in memory where I want to copy it to. And let's say I will put it at 300. And then I have to set a mode. And the mode I give, it's actually exactly the same as the mode for the put command. So in this case, I'm just going to need put replace mode. And as you can see, yes, it copied the box over. And I can do it like again, and it copies the box off. So it's very similar to the put command, except having to be in the screen, then getting it into memory, into a variable, and then later putting it only in the screen where I am right now, I can just basically be completely free. So I might be writing to some buffer screen with my graphics commands, and then at the same time use RC copy through from somewhere in memory, grab a section and actually write it to my display screen. So I can show something on my display screen while my graphics commands are writing somewhere else. You have complete flexibility. So that's actually very, pretty cool. So I'm going back to my screen and I've created some code where basically I'm going to do the same pre-draw procedure. So I'm going to create my canvas like I created before in part 29. Then I'm going to bmove that buffer screen to my graph buffer that I created. As we saw in the template, I used this. And then I'm going to draw all these sprites with the text inside them, and actually going to bmove that to my sprite buffer. And sprite buffer is just an address I defined, which is basically somewhere in my graph buffer plus 32,000. So it's right behind the canvas screen that I'm storing. And in this case, I'm going to start off with a really simple procedure, which basically says move your graph buffer to your logical screen. So my background will be there. And then after each key press, I'm going to do two moves. First, I'm going to, from the sprite buffer, from coordinates 0.0 with a width and a height of 16 pixels. And I'm going to copy that to my logical screen, in this case at position 200, 200, and I'm going to use mode 7. And then I'm going to do the big logo, which was at 400.0. And which is 96 pixels high and 32 wide and 32 pixels high, and copy that to my logical screen to coordinates. So this is the first step in my using the RC copy command. And as you saw, yeah, I did the B move to copy my screen over. And then as you can see, it's putting the sprite and it's putting the big logo in screen. And of course, this one is very simple, but it means I can use these commands to, instead of using the put commands with all these array animations, I can actually use these commands to put the objects also. And that's the first thing I'm going to do. So in this stage, yeah, basically the preparations are still exactly the same. And here also, yeah, I'm going to use bmove to actually put the background in my buffer screen and my logical screen, that both that I'm going to swap. This is exactly the same like in part 29. This is exactly the same like in part 29. Instead of putting the background with an sput command, I'm now going to use the bmove command to put the background. And then, yeah, write the coordinates just exactly like I did, draw the mask like I did. But instead of using the put command, I'm using the rc copy command, which, yeah, it looks a bit intimidating like this because it's like a really long line of code. And in this case, from the sprite buffer, yeah, I'm going to get the coordinates of this mask, put it in the buffer screen in these coordinates, and same the put mode 1, which I explained in part 29, to you do the masking. And then, of course, the drawing of the sprites is also very similar, like with the put command, except, yeah, the lines are a little bit longer because I have to set the source coordinates and destination coordinates in one command. So instead of getting it into a variable, writing that variable, I'm just directly copying it over. Yeah, with, again, with all the numbers, looks a little bit intimidating, but it's actually, you have, just have to know where the sprites are on your canvas, and then it's really easy to copy it over. So the animation should look exactly the same like we saw in part 29. And except for this, when I press the spacebar, I'm going to do an end step, which basically means I'm going to write the start coordinates again into the buffer, and then do the same procedure, but it will basically mean they will go back to the start position, and then it will end. You will see the effect when it's going. So let's run this program. And as you can see, yes, this is working exactly the same way as it was working with the put commands. And as we can see also, the speed is actually very similar. So the rc copy command, when you're not working a Blitter, and especially if you run it from the interpreter, the speed is actually exactly the same as the put command, especially for these little sprites. And the bmove command was also generally the same speed as the sput command. So we didn't do anything for the performance. We just used a different method to move them around. And as we saw, yeah, it's still too slow bmove to do a whole screen animation. So we need to find some way to increase the performance. And yeah, the putting of the objects will probably not get any faster. So I probably have to look in the way I clean up the screen, because do we really need to clean up the whole screen? I very much doubt it. So we will end the animation so we can also see the end step sequence. And then I'm going to, yeah, again go into some visualizations to go to our thought process of cleaning up. So I will go, because we have this animation going on, and now it's just a still of the animation. And the screen is actually quite big, but the objects are not, they're not going into every coordinate of the screen. So the easiest way to go about this is actually check, like, how much do we really need to clean up at the minimum? And the first step would be like, well, my logo is just going back and forth. So that's actually only those 32 pixels I have to clean up, which I can do using a bmove command. And for the sprites, the simplest way without thinking further ahead is actually determine what the highest point is that they're going to get into the screen and what the lowest point is that they are going to get into the screen, because that's not the whole screen. And I've calculated both of those, and I should be able to get some speed advantage by just cleaning up those parts, because the other parts are unaffected anyway. I don't have to put them on screen again and again. And that's the first step I prepared, which was my 4, I think. So everything is exactly the same, except for the cleanup procedure. And the cleanup is now basically limited to the scan lines where the animation will be. So this one is the coordination of the logo. So basically, I looked at the scan line where it is, multiplied it by 80, and put that in my address. So I'm going to look at graph buffer plus the scan line. And those 32 lines, which means in monochrome 2560 bytes, I'm going to copy over directly into the exact location in my buffer screen that I'm drawing to. And I'm going to do the same for the sprites. Basically, from the top coordinate that the sprites will be, which is this address, I'm going to copy to exactly the same location in my buffer screen from my source, but like directly copying over, and then using this amount of data, which is still quite a lot, but it's way less total than the 32,000 bytes. So this is something, the cleanup should actually be almost like within one vertical blank even. And remember, with get and put, or sget and sput, I would not be able to do this. So the freedom that bmove gives me as a direct memory manipulation command gives me more freedom in cleaning up. the cleaning up the canvas before I put the new sprites again. And of course, the rest of the procedure is unaffected. It's exactly the same like it was before. So the only thing I changed was the cleanup. And I'm curious, and the surprising but not entirely surprising thing is that actually the animation looks just as slow. And how is that possible, you might think? And actually, the answer to that one is actually quite simple. Because remember, apart from just doing the animation, I'm also waiting for a vertical blank, which means, in this case, if I go back into my code, I'm waiting for a vertical blank, which means this cleanup part is actually, it's like 20% faster than it was before, or maybe even a little bit more. So if I would not do the vSync and measure the two procedures like the previous one and this one, I would see that this one is faster. But because I'm waiting for the vertical blank, there's just more wait time in this case. And it means I can theoretically do a little bit more within the same and like within the same loop and have the same animation speed. So that's actually good news. But at the same time, yeah, I'm waiting for a vSync, because if I don't, my animation will get messed up with the masks. It will not display correctly. So I need more speed advantage. I need to add more performance even to be able to be so fast that I'm actually I am before the previous vertical blank. It's a bit difficult to explain, but instead I think this one is like taking three vertical blanks to complete, or two point something, which means there's more wait time and it will still be three vertical blanks, just as it was like before in the previous code. And there are actually other options that I have to clean up and to show this. So we went already from this total cleanup to just this, which gives us some, the routine is faster, but the animation doesn't get faster. But if I look at my sprite animation, actually the only things I have to clean up is actually I have to clean up this big logo at the bottom. So that is the area that I have to clean up. And remember, my sprites are sort of following in each other's coordinates. So in every screen, the only one I have to clean up is actually the last one. Because the letter A in the next screen, in the next one, it will actually be at the position where the letter I is now. So the masking procedure, which creates this white circle, and then the sprite on top, that part will take up for that part of the cleanup. So I only have to clean up the last sprite, because it's at this point, the objects are put on top of each other. So the masking and the putting of the objects will take care of the cleanup, except for the last sprite, which means these two are the only ones I have to clean up. And there's two ways to go about it. What I can do is actually determine the coordinates for those objects, like this diamond with the letter A and this big logo, and then use an rccopy command to copy them over from the original canvas, thus replacing it with the original background again. Another way I can do it is actually get the coordinate and the height of the objects and using the bmove command to basically do the entire set of bytes, so the 32 and 16 scan lines, because both should be pretty fast. And it's hard to predict which one will be faster, but I just did a test. And the interesting thing is, if we go into the cleanup, because as you can see, both commands are there. So this is the cleanup part for the logo, and this is the 32 lines I did, which we saw before. And after measuring, I actually saw that this one is actually faster than doing an RC copy. So I can also do an RC copy from the graph buffer, with these coordinates, and then copy it over to the buffer screen. But actually, this is slower because it's a raster copy. It's slower than just a really plain B move for the vertical lines, the horizontal lines, sorry. And the cleanup of the old sprites, in this case also, my cursor is acting a little bit funny, but this cleanup, this fixed pattern needs, I need only one cleanup, which I explained before, which means the last sprite in the screen, in this case, is at array position 23, because there was something inserted while I was at the other screen. So in my screen, my last sprite is now, the coordinates are not no longer in array position 22, but in 23. And I can do an RC copy in this case. I can just get the coordinates from the XPUT 23 and YPUT with a dimension of 16 by 16 pixels and copy it to the buffer screen to the exact same coordinates in replace mode, of course. But actually, in this case, also a B move. And I did a measurement, performance measurement. If I use a B move for these 16 scan lines, it's still 0.15% faster. And that's because Bmove is just way faster. It doesn't have to calculate that like this raster and stuff. It's just move the bytes and don't think of anything else. So in this case, for performance sakes, I'm using a Bmove in both cases. So I am using this method, which means I'm cleaning up more of the screen, but the method I'm using is so much faster still, or still slightly faster. So it's in this case, the best way to do it. Which case, I have to determine the coordinates for Y put, and because I have to put this variable, so I have to add this number two times, it's better to calculate it only once and write it into a long word variable, in this case cleanup. Say it's 80 times the coordinate of Y put, and then I say okay, from my graph buffer plus this shift, like based on the Y coordinate of the last sprite, I'm going to copy over those 16 lines, meaning 1280 bytes, to my buffer screen at exactly the same position. And yeah, I have to put this cleanup outside because it means this calculation is done only once instead of twice, so it's better performance. And also the bmove command doesn't like it if I say like graph buffer plus 80 times y put, because this is using normal word values instead of long word values. It doesn't like this calculation. The bmove command will fail, because for the addresses it really wants to have a long word value. So that's something important to keep in mind. And yeah, does it work? Well, if I do a shift F10, we can see, yeah, it's doing everything. And now we can see that the animation is actually a lot faster. And even after compiling, I did a performance measurement. Compared to the one from part 29, after compiling, this animation now is 30% faster. A good 30%, which means I think in part 29 the every animation steps took like three vertical blanks to complete, and now it takes about two vertical blanks to complete. So it's still not completely smooth, like it's not running at 30 is like 72 frames per second, but it's more like running at like 35 frames. So it sometimes needs a little bit extra time, but most of the time it's almost one step per two vertical blanks. So we actually improved the performance quite a lot. Which is pretty cool, I think. And it shows that thinking about what's the minimum amount of stuff I have to do, and always think like, what's the method where I have to move the minimum amount of bytes, or I have to do the minimum amount of calculation. And in this case, it meant doing the bmove command. But actually, I can also use the rcCopyCleanup method. But I think, so in this case, I'm using the method I did here. So I'm using rccopy to copy those pieces of the raster of the background to my buffer screen. And just to show you that, yes, that also works. And I think in this case, the animation from the interpreter, the animation is about the same speed. But when compiling, I could see a difference, and it's like a few percent, is not a lot. But it's better to use the bmove command for cleanup whenever you can, especially if there's nothing on the left that you want to keep there. But that's just part of the background. In this case, it doesn't matter. And of course, because it was a repetitive pattern, it was very easy to use. And it's just a matter of determining like what's actually happening, what do I want to happen in the screen, and what is the way to have as little as possible calculations within my loop and the least amount of memory that I need to move. And if something is like in this case, the bmove first rccopy is almost the same. But this was just slightly faster after measuring the performance. So that was a bit some basics of optimizing our animation routine. We have learned a lot today. We learned how to use the rccopy command to move graphics around by using raster copies. And then we learned about a cleanup procedure, looking at the amount of calculations and bytes we want to move, and then the calculation we want to do to optimize our cleanup procedure. And of course, the cleanup procedure with the bmove I could actually also have done with the get and put command. So in this case, the rccopy command wasn't that much of an extra compared to part 29. Just the bmove would have done the trick. So why would I use it? Mostly because it's just more flexible than get put. So I don't have to get something beforehand. I can just have one canvas, and whatever I want to copy over, I'm completely free in doing so. And it's independent of the screen settings, like it is with bmove. So that's why I would still use rccopy for many of the cases. And yeah, it enables us to have this really simple and fast cleanup procedure, but in the end, the bmove was even faster, as we saw. And rccopy for moving graphics around, it also has some challenges compared to put, because it really is not a graphics command, and that is something we will address in the next video. But for now, I would like to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.